On today's adventure, we'll be going for a relaxing drive in the Great Smoky Mountains National Park to enjoy all the recent snow we just had. We'll be stopping at the Bypass Overlook to get a great view of downtown Gatlinburg and surrounding Smoky Mountains covered in snow. We'll also be stopping by Sugarlands Visitor Center that just reopened for a relaxing hike through the snow to enjoy the sights and sounds of Cataract Falls as we see how frozen this waterfall is before heading back home through downtown Gatlinburg to see how crowded the streets are right now. We woke up this morning to single-digit temperatures. Though it was very cold, the sun was finally out and just read that they were opening up a few things in the national park. I did end up catching these deer running across the field, which is always a beautiful sight, especially through the snow. In all the years we've lived in Tennessee, we've never had to shovel snow on our driveway, but sometimes if we get enough snow, I need to shovel it off our solar panels, which is what I need to do before hitting the road. We produce enough electricity to power everything in our home and store extra power in backup batteries if we do lose power. I just want to make sure we're maximizing the sun while I'm away. You can see Micah's fort to the left here, and Bree will be homeschooling the kids while I'm gone, so I made sure she had plenty of firewood inside while I was away, along with getting all the snow off our other vehicle in case she needs to go anywhere while I'm gone. Our first stop is at the Old Mill in Pigeon Forge. I just wanted to give you a quick look to see what it's like today. From there, I worked my way towards Gatlinburg, and we're gonna be taking a relaxing drive through the bypass, which is now open. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the views on the way to Sugarlands Visitor Center. We are now past where we got stopped up yesterday in our last video. So now we're gonna continue on where we couldn't go up here to the Sugarlands Visitor Center and see, maybe we can hike over to Cataract Falls real quick and see what the waterfall looks like right now. Even if we can't make it, just driving around here carefully and slowly is just so peaceful and relaxing. I hope you've been enjoying this drive so far. If you have, do us a huge favor, just simply hit that thumbs up button on the video And make sure you are subscribed to our channel. They're both simple, free, easy ways to support our efforts to make more videos just like this. So it says Highway 441 is closed. You can see some snow is just falling off the trees as we cross over this bridge. It's just so beautiful out right now. So I can't go straight, it is closed down, but I can turn into the visitor center here, which is what we're going to do. There's more people here than I expected. Well, let's park real quick and go check out the visitor center and go for a quick hike. So the visitor center just opened back up just a little bit ago. I went inside and confirmed that most of the roads are indeed closed. So we're limited to where I can bring you right now. Well, we are gonna go back here to this waterfall hike that we've done before. It's a short hike. It's one we recommend for people who can't go very far distances. I don't think this water fountain is going to see a lot of use today. But one thing that is going to see a lot of use today is this heated jacket. I'm so glad Bree grabbed this for me. It's been working out good. The last time I looked, it was about 21 degrees. So I did forget my gloves after doing all the work on the solar panels. Well, we're just gonna keep them in the pockets as much as I can. But you can see the Gatlinburg Trail straight ahead is one thing we could do, but we're gonna head over here to the left to Cataract Falls, bring you on a nice relaxing hike in the Smokies. And I'm already noticing it's a little more difficult to distinguish the trail with all the snow on the ground. It's not too difficult of a trail, so I don't think we'll get too lost. Look at the water coming through. This is just so peaceful and beautiful right now. I can hear the water up ahead. It's so quiet and peaceful. I just hear some birds off in the distance in the water. That's about it. I don't hear any vehicles, no city noises. I can see a few people on the trail up ahead. All these tree branches have accumulated right here. You can see all these little icicles down below. So this hike is certainly beautiful, but it is very cold not having gloves. I think I've learned my lesson. I'm always gonna double check for gloves if I'm heading out at this point, but I hope you guys are enjoying this walk so far. Let's check out this bridge right here. This trail doesn't have too many steps, and again, the distance is not too bad to get to the waterfall. I just love the sight of snow on green trees. It's just so beautiful. I'm truly grateful to be out here doing what I'm doing right now, just to have the physical ability to do it. God is just so good. I'm so grateful to be here right now. We're almost there. And just up around the corner is Cataract Falls. I can see a few people that are up here enjoying the view of the waterfall, taking some photos. Let me see if I can get some good clear video for you guys of the waterfall. Let's see if I can get you guys a little bit closer as carefully as I can. I'm watching my step. I can actually see some ice alongside the waterfall. This is just so beautiful. So there is a look at Cataract Falls here in the Great Smoky Mountain National Park. Hopefully your blood pressure went down a few degrees after sitting and watching that. I could go down this trail right here to the right, which in 8.3 miles would get me to Cove Mountain, or 11.2 miles, I'd make it to Laurel Falls. I don't think I'm going 11.2 miles, but actually we'll walk up just a little bit to see what we can see over here. Looks like I'm gonna have to navigate through this tree right here that went down during the storm. Ugh. I love the sound of the water down below. It's just so peaceful and quiet out here right now. Another tree that went down recently. I'll take walking a trail like this rather than just running in place on a treadmill any day. I just want to stop and give you a quick view from here. Okay, I won't lie. I'm just catching my breath. This has been nonstop incline. Whew, feels good. As tempting as it is to keep going and see what I can find, I don't want to deviate too far off of my hiking plan that I told Bree. I told her I was going to Cataract Falls, so I don't want to keep going off track too far if I ran into an issue. So we're going to turn back around and head back towards the car. So I've made it back to Cataract Falls and nobody's here. It's very, very quiet right now. Not a lot of people on the trail. So now that we've taken time to enjoy Cataract Falls and gone down the trail over here to the right for a little bit, let's work our way back down to the Sugarlands Visitor Center. As we're working our way back to the Sugarlands Visitor Center, I haven't seen too many people on the trail, though I just saw somebody with a Detroit Lions hoodie. So I asked them, are you guys from Detroit? They said yes. They're hardcore, lifelong Lions fans. So we talked a little bit about the upcoming Bucks versus Lions game. I will say, if my Bucks don't win, I will be excited for the Lions, because I know those fans have been dying to go to the Super Bowl for a long, long time. So we'll see the outcome of the game this next Sunday. Whatever the outcome, it should be a great game, but we've made it back to this bridge, which is just so beautiful right now. I'm not sure the camera is catching it very well, but every so often you'll just see little flurries of snow or little bits of snow coming off the trees from above. It's just so pretty and relaxing out here right now. As we come back to this first little bridge we initially crossed. As we've made it back to the visitor center, I gotta say, kudos to whoever knocked off all the snow on their solar panels here. So I made it back to the Sugarlands Visitor Center. I went inside and talked to some park rangers. Nothing new has opened up yet, so I won't be able to get over to Cades Cove or anything else at this point in time. So maybe tomorrow I'll get up early and rope drop Cades Cove. The theme park people who are watching this video understood what I just said. So let's leave the Visitor Center and head through Gatlinburg and see if we can get over to the Ogle Cabin. So I could take a right here to get to Cades Cove, but again, it's closed. So when Cades Cove does open up, I'll try my best to get over. Again, I could take a right here. You can see this is closed down here to the right to get to Newfound Gap and Cherokee. So let's go where we're able to go over here to the left and drive through Gatlinburg real quick. Crossing over the bridge here with all this snow on it. See the water off in the distance. It's so pretty. See a park ranger parked over here to the right to the Sugarlands Riding Stables that's closed down right now. And I could take the bypass here to the left to get to Pigeon Forge, which is what we came in on. But this time I'm gonna go straight again through Gatlinburg to head out over towards Roaring Fork Motor Nature Trail. It currently says that it's 28 degrees out right now with the sun. It doesn't feel too bad. But let's drive through Gatlinburg real quick and see how busy it is right now. It's currently 2 o'clock on a Wednesday afternoon, and I don't see many people walking the street, and there's not that much traffic right now at all. Looks like the sidewalk has a little bit of snow on it. Seems like there's a little more people on this side of town. So let's take a right here and see if we can get over towards Roaring Fork Motor Nature Trail. As we're at Airport Road and Cherokee Orchard Road, I got Minette Park up here to the right, and I can see some people doing some sledding along the hill over to the right. So if you're looking for a place to come do some sledding, if you're in downtown Gatlinburg, I'd come over here to Minette Park. Unfortunately, the road to the Ogle Cabin is closed right now. I've been debating whether I should just hike the 1.8 miles to the cabin. I'm very tempted to do it, but I kind of figured the time I get all the way over there, get back, I'm gonna be home later. So I think I wanna be able to spend more time with Bree and the kids tonight. So I'm gonna get home and maybe we'll come back here on a different day and I'll show you what the cabin looks like, hopefully covered in snow. But that's gonna wrap up today's video. I hope you guys have enjoyed this drive and hike to the waterfall. Until next time, we'll see you on the next adventure.